Okay, in this video, we're going to look at a couple more problems where we use mesh current method on circuits that involve a super mesh. So let's look at this circuit here. There's three meshes, and I have the mesh currents already defined. And here we have a current source that has two mesh currents defined through it, I2 and I1. So this tells us we have a super mesh. Now, in addition, what's different here than the previous problem we did with the super mesh is that there's a resistor, this 1 ohm resistor, that's in series with the current source that has the two mesh currents through it. So when you have a case like this where there's a series resistance with a current source with two mesh currents, that resistor is also part of the super mesh, and you can exclude the voltage across that resistor when you write your KVL equation. So, to indicate that, I'm going to draw an ellipse not only around the current source, but around that 1 ohm resistor that's in series with it. So, when we write our KVL equation, we're going to exclude the voltage across this current source as well as the current across this resistor that's in series with it. It's similar to a node voltage method when you have a super node. And there's a resistor in parallel with the voltage source that's part of a supernode. You can also make that parallel resistor part of the supernode. Well, here with supermesh, it's when you have a series resistance, you include that resistance with the supermesh. So let's start with the KVL for the supermesh. Okay. And the supermesh involves I1 and I2, since those are the two mesh currents through our current source. So I'm going to start here with the 6-volt source, and I'm going clockwise. And you see, this is the reason why it's a good idea to put your mesh currents always go in the same direction. Remember in a previous video, I said, well, you can pick your mesh currents going different directions if you want to. Well, that's only true if you don't have a super mesh. If you have a super mesh, then you do have to have all your mesh currents going the same direction. That's because if I had them go in different directions, well, I would run into a problem because I wouldn't know which way to go around the super mesh, right? If I had my mesh currents go in different directions, it would contradict going the same direction through the entire super mesh. So in order to go the same direction through a super mesh, you've got to have your mesh currents going the same way. So, okay, so I1 here is going minus the plus in voltage for the 6-volt source, so that's going to give us a minus 6 term in our KVL equation. Now I get to the 2 ohm resistor, so I'll have plus 2I1 and minus 2I3. Okay, then. Okay, now I go here, okay, because my super mesh involves I1 and I2. So now the 4 ohm resistor, I would get plus 4I2 and minus 4I3. And then my last term here in the super mesh is going to be the 8 ohm resistor, which only has I2 flowing through it, so that's plus 8I2. And that sums to zero. Okay, so that's the KVL for the super mesh. Okay, but now I have to do another KVL expression. I have to do it for I3. Okay, I3 wasn't part of the super mesh, so this is just a KVL for I3. And why wasn't I3 part of the super mesh? Well, I3 is not defined through this current source like I1 and I2 are. So for I3, I'll start at this 2 ohm over here. We'll get plus 2I3. That's the only mesh current through that 2 ohm resistor over at the right. Then the 4 ohm resistor will get plus 4I3 minus 4I2. Then at the 2 ohm resistor, the left one over here, we'll get plus 2I3 and then minus 2I1. All right, and that sums to zero. So after we're done with our KVL equations, you can see we're short one equation, right? Because we got three unknowns, I1, I2, I3, two equations. So to get the third equation, well, just like we did the previous problem, you look here at your current source. The difference of I1 and I2 is going to equal the current source value of 3 amps. And here it's I1 minus I2 because I1 is going in the direction of the arrow of the current source and I2 is going against. Okay, so the one that's going against is the one that's minus. So this is I1 minus I2 equal to 3. Okay, so now we have our three equations, three unknowns. If you go ahead and solve for the three currents, you should get the following. I1 comes out to 3.474 amps. I2, that's going to be 0. Right, it's 3 less than I1, so 0.474 amps. And then I3 you should get. See, I3 is equal to 1.105 amps. Alright, those are our answers for our mesh currents. Okay, let's do one more problem, and then we'll be finished with mesh current method, and we'll move on to other things in chapter 4 of the text, which is our last chapter of the quarter. So let's look at this circuit here. This circuit here has two super meshes, okay? Because see, we have two current sources, an independent current source of 5 amps and also a dependent current source of 3I0 that have two mesh currents defined through them. So you see, we'll exclude this current source from our KVL equation, and we'll exclude this current source from our KVL equation. Also notice that I0, the current that this dependent current source depends on, is defined over here for us. Okay, so first we're going to do our KVL, okay, for our super meshes, right? Since we have more than one here, we have two. Okay, so our super mesh here is going to be right like this. See, this is our super mesh because this current source involves I1 and I2. This current source involves I2 and I3. So I1, I2, and I3 is all involved with the super mesh. So we'll have this one super mesh, and then we'll have to have a separate KVL equation for I4, since I4 is not part of the super mesh because it doesn't go through, it's not defined through any of these current sources. Okay, so we'll just start right here. I'm going to start with the 6 ohm resistor. So the 6 ohm resistor will give me 6I2 in my KVL equation. And then the 2 ohm resistor up here only has I1 flowing through it, so that will give me plus 2I1. Okay, the 4 ohm resistor here only has I3 through it, so that will give me plus 4I3. And now I get to the 8 ohm resistor where I have two mesh currents defined through the 8, so I'll get two terms, so plus 8I3. And then minus 8I4. And that sums to 0. Okay, so you see that's the KVL for our mesh, or super mesh, excuse me. Now we do KVL for I4. So that's this loop right here. So I'm going to start at the 10 volt source, so going clockwise I get plus 10 volts. Then I'll have plus 8I4 minus 8I3. And then this 2 ohm resistor only has I4 through it, so plus 2I4. And that equals 0. Okay, so look here. When we're done with our super mesh KVL and our KVL for I4, we've got two equations, but we've got four unknowns, I1, I2, I3, and I4. So we've got to come up with two additional equations. And the way you do that, you guessed it, just like before, we look at our current sources, right? The value of the current source tells us the difference of our mesh currents defined to that current source. So here at the 5 amp, it's going to be I2 minus I1. Okay, so I2 minus I1 equals 5. Okay, then over here at the dependent current source, well, I2 is going in the arrow of the dependent source, and I3 is going again. So I3 is the minus 1. So we have I2 minus I3 is equal to 3I0. Okay, so now what happens is because of that dependent current source, another variable was defined into our system of equations here. So now we've got four equations, but there's five unknowns because of this I0. But that's okay. We know that when we have a dependent source, that's going to happen, that we're going to have to write the variable of that dependent source in terms of what we're solving for. We've seen this at least a couple of times before. So we got to look at our circuit, see where I0 is defined, which is over here, and then relate that to what we're solving for, which are the mesh currents. Well, I4 is defined going against the direction that I0 is given. So I0 is just equal to minus I4. So you see this is going to be minus 3 I4. All right, so now we have four equations, four unknowns, and we can go ahead and solve. And I'll just give you the answers here so you can check this on your own. I1 is equal to minus 7.5 amps. All right, so remember that minus tells us that I1 is really flowing the other way. It's really flowing counterclockwise. I2 also is really flowing counterclockwise because I2 is minus 2.5 amps. Okay, what else do we have here? We have I3, put it over here. I3 is equal to 3.93 amps. And I4 comes out to 2.143 amps. All right, so those are your mesh current answers. And like I've said many times before, once you have the answers from either mesh current method or no voltage method, make sure you can go back to the circuit and find any current, any voltage, any power for all the elements that are in that circuit.